Bon Jovi. These gods of rock have had a career spanning over 25 years. They've sold an incredible 120 million records worldwide and given the UK 18 top 10 singles and 5 number one albums. Tonight, here just for you, they'll be performing some of their biggest hits. On a steel iron, wanted, wanted, dead or alive. We catch up with John in his native New Jersey.
No, I'm not kidding. I own a good portion of that helicopter.
And reveal how they nearly didn't survive the pressures of touring.
The Beatles, did it make it over that bump? Guns N' Roses, did it make it over that bump? You get to that place and then you teeter or totter, you know?
We
weren't born
to follow. We also find out what the future holds for the band.
I know what it is that I do and I know how to do it. So I'm not looking to do anything else right now. I think every artist is still waiting to paint his masterpiece.
This is Bon Jovi, One Night Only.
Play your game, love.
live and up close and personal for you tonight. It's Bon Jovi, everyone. John Bon Jovi. Thank you. And of course, the Brotherhood guitar legend, Richie Sambora. On the drums, Tico Torres. And on the keyboards, David Bryan. It is a pleasure and an honour to have you guys on this show in the UK. Thanks. It really is. What have you got in store for us tonight?
Lots of hits, a couple different versions of a couple of songs that I don't think people are used to hearing. And you watched us work them out an hour ago. Not even. Half of the beauty. And then see how it goes from there. Maybe we'll just sit around and take requests for an hour or two. I don't know.
We're so excited about the show tonight. Bon Jovi, everyone. This is going to be one rocking evening. So feel free to push back the furniture and let your hair down. Not only will you see the guys play some of their biggest hits. Earlier this week, John opened the doors of his New Jersey estate to give us an insight into the story that is Bon Jovi.
Might as well wait a minute. They're gonna go right overhead. It's probably mine.
Yeah. No, I'm not kidding. I own a good portion of that helicopter.
New Jersey is what it is. The Sopranos is New Jersey. That house where Tony Soprano would walk out to get the newspaper in the morning, I swore was the place that my parents owned. I swear it is. Close enough to Manhattan and far enough away at the same time. It's a place where people have to work even harder to get out of shadows, you know, shadows of Manhattan. I lived here my whole life. I mean, this is the place where I was born. That's where I live. These are my people. It's a crazy list of talents that the world know, from Sinatra to Whitney Houston to Springsteen. What we had here that really did help me believe was they made records 30 minutes from your high school, from your parents' kitchen. So it wasn't as though we were looking to Led Zeppelin and going, we want to be that. The kids that grew up on the shore here were more likely to say, we want to be like that, because they made the impossible. Possible.
About a bottle that you drink, traveling your love. seen a million faces, and I like them all. I'm a cowboy, on a steel as I want it, dead or alive. I'm a cowboy, and that's on my side. Want it, dead or
of Living on a Prayer. You do not want to miss that. Keep it here for Bon Jovi, One Night Only. It's One Night Only with rock legends Bon Jovi.
Oh, it was a close set, but we broke in.
And earlier in the evening, I got to go backstage and talk with the guys about their 25 years in the business. Hello, Bon Jovi.
Hello, Bon.
Hello.
Guys, can you tell us, what is it like walking out on stage as one of the biggest rock bands in the world?
50 or 50,000, you still want to be great. You want to be the best you can be. The size doesn't matter.
Although...
Lady.
No, I have heard you actually say that you would like to play the desert, sell it out more than once. Is that true then?
Sure it is.
Yeah?
I mean, I like playing, you know, there are those who say, oh, I like the intimacy of a small room. It's because you can't sell at the big place.
Right.
And we can.
And you will again
and
again.
We do.
Exactly. Now, obviously, you guys have been through so much over the years. What's the closest you've been to death?
Airplane issues.
Probably the closest.
You know, that's in Canada. A
couple crashes.
Plane ran off the runway that time, yeah, in Canada. A couple of those serious turbulence pockets over the years where, you know, you start sweating. And
we had a real bad storm. We were trying to get through the middle of, like, a couple of lightning storms, and the tail didn't make it, and we did one of those.
Oh, my goodness. What's the craziest thing you've heard about yourself? Rumors flying around, bizarre stories?
All the crazy stuff you heard about me is true.
Propagating the myth, which is everywhere.
There's loads of two-headed love childs all around the world.
Oh,
yes.
Yeah,
I heard a crazy story, yeah.
They're all over.
What do you think when fans tell you they've got married to your songs, they've made babies to your songs?
Like you named their children Bon Jovi. We had someone come up to
really?
Us not too long ago.
Yeah, the kid's name was Jovi, right?
Bon Jovi. Oh. I think it was Bon Jovi.
Full Bon Jovi.
I met him. You met him too, right?
In Canada.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you meet a lot of bands who've actually said, you know, you guys have inspired us, you guys have got us into music?
Yeah, there's a fair amount of that. You know, when you're around this long, you can't help but have, you know, been on someone's turntable at some point.
They start calling you Mister.
Sir.
That's all I heard about.
Sir.
Well, look, we're really psyched about this evening, so thank you very much
for
being here. Bon Jovi, One Night Only. Thank you. The next song hit number one in countries all over the world. And it was inspired by the man who famously said, I did it my way, old Blue Eyes himself, Frank Sinatra. Get ready for another Bon Jovi classic, It's My Life.
Yeah.
You know, Richie and I have a pretty unique approach to songwriting. We try to make sure that the lyric can be universal and timeless. If they spoke German or Japanese, the message was universal. When you see a second generation come up and take something like a Living on a Prayer and embrace it, it worked. The beauty of that song is it was a true collaboration, really unique sounding song. You know, that bass line is right out of Motown, but it's updated because Richie was thinking Joe Walsh and Peter Frampton with that talk box. The storyline was right out of, you know, New Jersey storytellers' handbooks of hope and faith and optimism and getting through. Having a double chorus. We need a chorus that's gonna beat the chorus. And then, by the way, we're gonna change keys at the end. I walked out of there and said to Richie, "Now, it's okay." I didn't think it was good enough to even make the record. We should give it away to this movie called The Disorderlies, starring a rap group called The Fat Boys. It was like a Three Stooges movie, and they needed a song, and we said, give them Living on a Prayer. And Richie says, I'll kill you. There's no way.
This feels like the Elvis special in 1969 to me, so I just figured I gotta break into something. Have a little bit of fun.
That's all right, mama. That's all right with you. That's all right now, mama. I'd say anything you do. That's all right. That's all right. That's all right now, mama. Any way you do. My mom, she done told me. Papa done told me too. Son, that girl, you're fooling me. She ain't no good for you. That's all right. That's all right. That's all right now, mama. Get it where you do. Bobby! Bobby!
Bon Jovi will be performing their brand new single for the very first time on UK TV. And John reveals how the band came close to breaking point. Don't miss it. Performing their new single for the first time on TV. But now it's time for a song with a very special place in the history of Bon Jovi. It was the worldwide smash hit that brought the band back into the charts following their huge success in the 80s. And it typifies the never say die spirit of Bon Jovi. This is Keep the Faith.
Yeah.
tips of society's lies. When I like what I see no more, sometimes I wish my eyes were blind. Sometimes I wait forever, I stand out in the rain, so no one sees me crying when I wash with the pain. For the father, if they not run, I can't erase.
We went from nothing to the skyrocket of fame, got to that crossroad where most famous bands that get to that crossroad, the Beatles, did it make it over that bump? Guns N' Roses, did it make it over that bump? You get to that place and then you teeter or totter, you know? The end of the New Jersey tour, we had done four consecutive 200 plus show tours. The physical and mental burnout was evident. But we were so tired that we just didn't realize it. Believe me, everybody's lives were out of whack. Nobody stole money from each other. Nobody was sleeping with each other's girlfriends. If they did drugs, they did their drugs. It was so mundane, you couldn't even believe it. And I had a friend who was managing Aerosmith by the name of Tim Collins. And he had brought this man in who wasn't a psychiatrist. Nobody laid on the couch. He didn't have a, you know, prescribed medication and push his glasses up and ask about your mom's. And what he brought to the table was common sense. So we got in a room. Initially, everybody looked down, didn't want to talk to each other about any of them. And then we got through it. And then everybody put their hand and said, I'm in. Hence the album cover, the beginning of the second decade, and never looked back.
Everybody wants something. Making a living ain't what we're living for. A rich man or a poor man, a pawn or a king. You could live on the street, you could rule the whole world, but it don't mean one damn thing. What do you got if you ain't got love? Whatever you got just ain't enough. You're walking the road, but you're going nowhere. Trying to find your way home, but there's no one there. And who do you hold in the dark at night? When you want to give up, it's still worth the fight. You can have all the things that you've been dreaming of, but if you ain't got someone that you're afraid to lose, everybody needs just one someone to tell them the truth. Well, maybe I'm a dreamer, but I still believe. I believe in hope, I believe the change can get us up off our knees. I don't wanna have to talk about it, how many songs we gotta sing about it. How long you gonna live without it? Why does someone have to doubt it? Someday we'll figure it
You're walking a road, but you're going nowhere. Trying to find your way home, but there's no one there. Who do you hold in the dark of night? When you want to give up, you're still worth the fight. You can have all the things we've been dreaming of. You ain't got love, it's all just keeping score. You ain't got love, what do you do?
Another hit there. Bon Jovi will be right back with a special treat for all the ladies in the house. Bon Jovi, One That Only continues in a few minutes.
We can't pretend that nothing's changed. Living in the shadows of the love we made. Back when we were beautiful, before the world got small, before we knew it all. Back when we were innocent, I wonder where it went. Let's go back and find it. Sha-la-la, sha-la-la.
But the you in me, it's still alive. Now am I blessed or am I cursed? 'Cause the way we are ain't the way. When we are
I know what it is that I do, and I know how to do it. So I'm not looking to do anything else right now. I think every artist is still waiting to paint his masterpiece. Don't think for a moment that Keith Richards wouldn't echo that statement and say, yeah, the Stones are still striving to make their best record. And no matter how hard you work on any given record from the inception in the notebook to the release of it, when you look back on them, the reason you made the next one is you had something else to say that you thought you could say better. You're in the pursuit of perfection and hopefully living in the world of happiness. And then it's, you know, it's fuel enough to go on and do it again.
Okay. We are nearly at the end of the show. How have you found this evening, John?
Oh, everything's been great. Had a great old time up here, you know. It's, like, nice to be with a bunch of friends and family here. This is very nice. It's been great. Thank you.
Now, when will we be able to see you guys again in the UK?
In June. We'll come back. We'll be outdoors in the summertime. As soon as it warms up.
I think you've got some friends joining you at that gig as well, by the sounds of it. What a night this has been. Let's hear it one more time for Bon Jovi. Thanks so much to our wonderful audience. And thank you for you at home for joining us for Bon Jovi One Night Only. We're going to finish with a song that was a huge hit in the UK and earned the guys a Grammy, a modern Bon Jovi classic. Who says you can't go home? Good night.
Next weekend here on ITV1, they're back together as a five-man group for the first time in 15 years. But what's the truth behind their reunion? As they make their latest album and plan the tour, we'll access all areas with Take That next Saturday, straight after The X Factor at 9:30.